So, good morning everyone. Welcome to a new episode on this channel. Today, it's about a new species we are looking here. Not a new species to science, but a new species to us. And actually not only the species, but also the genus. So, in this area, we are looking for Thuriocosmos leighti. And Thuriocosmos leighti, just a second, is actually one of the most beautiful Thuriocosmos species, in my opinion, because they have this silver shine on all of the legs and this amazingly contrasty orange and black tones on the abdomen. So yeah, really looking forward to find them. They mainly live under rocks and rotten logs and wood. So that's basically the thing we're looking for, and turn around as many as possible. And on our way on this very location, we already found some monkeys playing around in the upper parts of the forest, and we took some videos of that. So we'll just run the intro, give you a little bit of an impression, and then of course in the meanwhile we're looking for this very species, and hopefully we're going to find it. So very tight schedule, but very happy that we found a juvenile species of Thuriocosmos leighti. It's not fully grown. There may be even more out there somewhere, but for the moment it's just mind blowing that we found one in such a short amount of time. It took us actually around 30 minutes. The three of us were walking in the forest, turning around some wooden rotten logs. And of course, always turning it then back to the place where it belongs to. But anyway, not much time to waste here. Thuriocosmos leighti, beautiful specimen, juvenile, freshly molted. Yeah, we couldn't be happier. And let's run the footage and give you some more impressions about it. So the genus Thuriocosmos was established in the year 1903 by the French arachnologist Simon, and since then the species count just raised almost every 2 years. So at the moment there are around 21 different species recognized and valid, but just recently two more species of Thuriocosmos get described in the year 2019 by Radan Kaderka, another arachnologist who is specializing in Thuriocosmos and other small Theraphosinae. So we are now at around 23 different species of Thuriocosmos, and certainly Thuriocosmos leighti is one of the most beautiful ones. But of course there are other species, just as Thuriocosmos chicoi or Thuriocosmos ritae, which are just amazingly colored as well. So Thuriocosmos leighti was described in the year 1999 by a French arachnologist called Sébastien Vol. And because of the type locality of Villa Vincenzio, we actually know that this is the species we found here, because we were very close to it and there is just no chance that there is another species of Thuriocosmos within this range. So if you keep Thuriocosmos leighti at your place, just make sure you don't keep them at too low temperatures. They really like and enjoy temperatures around the 25 degrees Celsius range, or 23 to 25 degrees Celsius range, because they don't really dig deep burrows and they don't tend to cool off as much as maybe other fossorial genera and species. So they have to have like a little bit on the other side. That's what they enjoy the most probably, and they grow easily quick, so at around 1.5 years you should have a mature female when you raise them from extremely tiny spiderlings. So keep that in mind if you start with the Zuriocosmos. They are extremely small as juveniles and spiderlings, so you need to have the right food source for them. That's actually the area where we found Zuriocosmos laetii. And just about of the history in this very forest, you can see rotten looks like this. Just beneath we found one, and here's the trail again. So normally make sure you don't walk out of any trail because you disturb wildlife, but here in this case it's actually not a reserve or anything, so if you're cautious enough then shouldn't be any problem. That looks like a papaya tree with all these spines, extremely beautiful. So just heading back to the, see, like this, it's a rotten log, and underneath parts like this it's actually extremely great to find something. Yeah, a lot of termites in here, but no Zuriocosmos.
Generally speaking, Zuriocosmos is an awesome genus to keep, and at the moment actually I don't really have any at my collection, but that's gonna change for sure, because now we found the Zuriocosmos species in the wild and it is just incredible and fascinating to see them out there. It's nice to see protected areas for them, but it's not so nice to see that there is a lot of agriculture use going on. Of course, the local population needs to earn some money in somewhat, but in the end, a lot of deforestation is happening. So Zuriocosmos laetii is an awesome species to keep. And of course, there are other members of the genus Zuriocosmos, which I can just greatly recommend to get as a pet tarantula. They don't tend to get that many out there, and I have no idea what I'm talking about.